Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. Tonight we're going to look into Spring integration and the built-in SftP message handler from Spring, which makes it even easier for us to integrate with the SftP servers, like upload and download from these SftP servers. We're going to create a messaging gateway, which will be the one that sends the file to the channel that we are listening to, and then we have a service activator which will tell us which channel we are listening to, and then it will also trigger the handler code that we will create a bean out of in just a minute. So just to show you the setup, I have a SftP server running locally on my own machine as in Docker. So I have a SftP right here, SftP. And then we have our Spring application over here, and then we have the SftP handler, SftP messaging handler, which is right here. And then we have something called a channel. This is a channel. And then we have something called a gateway. And this is actually just an interface which will be implemented by the Spring integration. And then I will create a REST controller, and that is just to trigger the whole flow. So then that means that I will create a REST controller right here. And then we will open up our browser on some kind of URL, and then we will trigger this closed code right here in the REST controller. The REST controller will then call the gateway with the file that we will create a file in this code also here. So we'll create some kind of file in here. And then we will call the gateway with that file, transport it right up here. Then that will then be transported to the channel. And since our SftP handler is listening, eavesdropping on this channel right here, then the file will be sent to the SftP handler. And then that will then, because of the configuration we are setting up, then we'll actually place it into the upload folder inside the SftP server. So that is the purpose of tonight's exercise or demonstration, and I want to use the SftP messaging handler, which is built into Spring integration. First of all, how did I create this project right here? I pressed File, I pressed New, I pressed Project, and then I chose Spring Initializer. I have JDK 13. Next, I chose Gradle just because I prefer it. And then I chose 11, Java version 11. Then I press next, then I chose Lombok, then I chose Spring Web. Then I found the integration, which is right here. And then I press next and finish. And then I found a dependency for the SftP part of the Spring integration. I added that manually. You can see the integration is actually up here. But if I want to use the SftP handler, messaging handler, then I need to add this line right here. So I added that line. And then we can get started. The first step that is a configuration. So let us create an upload configuration. We need to configure where is our SftP server located, etc. So we will create a configuration right here. And I need to create, I want to return a message handler right here, message handler. And this is our upload handler, which is right here. And the upload handler, it takes a file. So file like this. Oh, this is actually not right. Sorry, it does not take a file. Our upload handler is actually, let me create a service activate right here. Then we have an input a channel, and then this is the channel that we're going to listen to, and this could be upload file. And then I want to create it as a bean also. And then the next thing is that we need the SftP message handler, which is this one right here. And then we could call this message handler equals new SftP message handler. And this takes a session factory as an argument. So we need to create that up here. I have cheated a little bit. I have placed some code in the clipboard, and that is exactly the default SftP session factory. I've created some other videos about how to use this. But actually, just a long story short, is actually that this is where we configure the host, the port, if we allow unknown keys, which we are going to in this situation right here, it's not recommended for production situations. Of course, it's not that secure right now. It accepts all hosts, so it doesn't care about which server that actually runs there, and that makes us vulnerable, of course, to phishing. But because this is my own machine, and this is just for demo and development, then it's okay. So factory set user, set passwords, and then we return the factory right here. That means that when we go and create our message handler, SFTP message handler right here, then we can add this method right here as an argument. So that means that now I've actually created the message handler. If you wanted to, we could actually just stop there and then just say return message handler, and that's actually it. But I would like to configure what should be the file name be, and where should it actually place the file on the SFTP. So we have not set that anywhere. So let us just do that. We can set the remote directory expression, and I'll try to use the string. Usually I'm actually using the other methods, it's just because I'm used to that. Then I say new literal expression like this, and then I write upload. Okay, let's keep it to that. Then we don't get any surprises. But I think you can actually just use the set remote directory expression and then just string. And then if you don't need any expression right here, then you could just set you just use the string method instead. But let us move on. So that was the step one. Then we have a file name generator, and here we can use a lambda. This takes a message. So that means that then we could actually use a message and get the original file name, get the payload, and then cast this to a file, and then get the original file name, and then and set that. But for tonight's exercise and demonstration, then we are just going to, a message that has both the headers and has a payload, and the payload will be a file in our situation. But we need to, of course, when we're decoding this in Java like this, then of course we need to first ask, is it a file, then cast it to the file, and then get the file name, and then return that as the new file name also. But I'm going to do something a bit more fun and fast instead. And then I'm going to say my text file, and then I'm going to write percentage S like this, underscore, then .txt. And then we're going to format the string, and then we're going to add local date time dot now. So that means that then I will get my text file, it will always be named this, and then plus the current time as inside the name of the file right here. So this is actually it. So this actually, now we have set up the message handler, SFTP message handler. We have set up the session factory right here, which is used in the message handler right here. But we need to set up a gateway so we can post some files on this channel right here, upload file channel. So let us create a gateway. A new Java class, and it's an interface. So I'll just tick off interface, and then I'll say upload messaging gateway, and I don't know, annotate this with the messaging gateway like this. Then I'll go create one method. I could have created multiple methods, of course. It does not return anything. It's just, again, it's an interface we're creating, so we're not going to implement the method. It's going to be implemented automatically. And then we can say upload file. And then we can give a file as an argument. And then we need to give an annotation of gateway. And in here we need to set the request channel. And the request channel here is upload file. It needs to match the other channel that we set on the inbound input channel, or else nothing will happen. Upload file. And then I'm going to create a REST controller. Upload REST controller, and this REST controller, that this is what's going to trigger the gateway REST controller. And then I'm going to add required args constructor from Lombok. That means that then I can add my member variable, and then I will automatically get a constructor if I add the modifier final. So private final upload messaging gateway like this, and gateway, let me just call it gateway. So then I get a constructor, and then it will actually be wired directly into the constructor. So that is the cool thing about Lombok and require arch constructor and Spring. Yeah, very useful. So, and then I'll create a git mapping so we can trigger. We can trigger a file being uploaded, and this will be named API upload, and then we'll create a variable in the path like content. And then we have public string, I'll return strings, which returns, so we can see something in the browser. It's always fun to, it's always best to return something actually in general from methods if you can. And then we call this upload file. And then we have a path variable right here, and that is the content, string content. I'm also going to add a request parameter. That's just to add a little bit more, so it's a little bit more fun, request parameter. And this could be called named extra. And then we're gonna have string extra. Actually, I did not need this part right here when I have the string extra right here, but that's okay. Then we create a string, and then we say this resulting content, result content. This is the content of a file, and I want to add I want to add something. Hello, we have uploaded, and then the content comes here, presented as. And then with some extra, let us create a new line there. New line, backslash n, with some extra stuff. And then we write percent s again. And let us format the string. Oh, format like this. And then we write content, comma, extra. So this is the resulting string. And this is what we're going to return, just so we have something to look at in the browser. Return content. And then we're going to create a new file. File utils from Apache comments dot write string to file. And we need a new file. File equals new file. And then we say temp. And then we say my temp file dot txt. And we're going to, if it already exists, then let us delete it so then we can run this program multiple times. So file.exist, then file.delete, like this. And write to string. First we have the file, this is the file, then we have the resulting content. And then we have the encoding, which is UTF-8. And then we're going to add a exception to the method signature, like this, IO exception. Then if it happens, then we'll just get, the browser will just experience a 501 internal server error, and we will get an exception in our program. So this was actually, then we need to call a gateway, or else nothing happens, gateway.uploadFile. And then we say, here's the file. I think this is it, actually. Yes, let's try to run the program and see what happens. I can prepare the browser with the URL while it starts up. So let me say localhost 8080. API, then some content, the content could be, what should the content be, chocolate, and then we have some chocolate, and then we have, extra could be wine gums. But before that, let me just look in FileZilla. I have a FileZilla connection right here. And I already have some files uploaded, so I'll just delete the file so we have an empty FileZilla, empty SFTP server to begin with. This is FileZilla, and I'm connected right now to 000. So, and the user is Mike, you can also see that up in the top right there. So let us try to press enter on this URL right here. Then our REST controller should be triggered. Localhost 8080. Hello, we have uploaded chocolate with some extra stuff, wine gums, and we cannot see the line change because this is HTML, so we do not see the new line right here. So let us see in FileZilla. Do we have a file? Press F5, upload. Yes, it's right there. There's a file. Let's try to view it. Yes. Hello, we have uploaded chocolate. Now I can see the new line, right? It's right there, the line shift. And then we have the with some extra stuff, wine gums. I'm so proud of myself. It's a huge success as usual. So the code actually works. And we can also see here, there's a lot of SFTP log output right here, control output. So yeah. And of course, if you don't want it, then you can go and target this specifically and say you only want the error information if you don't want all the SFTP stuff written out. Yeah, let us run it a couple of other times. Now we have created a method, right? Chocolate, instead of chocolate, what you write, it may be white chocolate. Instead of wine gums, we could have a lollipop, enter. And we can see here, as soon as we get the response, then the code has been run. And let us go to FileZilla again. And F5 again. And there we got another file. Let us try to review that also, and then see that we can see that it's white chocolate and lollipop. White chocolate and lollipop. Yes. I am so happy and I'm so proud of myself. Thank you very much for watching. If you have any questions, the reason why I actually made this video was because there was someone in the community that actually asked me the question, could you please show an example where we are using the SFTP message handler, because I have created some other SFTP videos where I use the default SFTP session factory directly instead of using the handler and the Spring integration flow, so to say, and the channels and all that. Then I've been using this directly instead. Now this is an example where we actually have been using the SFTP message handler. There's a lot of there's actually also something called cache SFTP, something cache handler, something like that. I need to look into that in another day. But there's something we can actually create. It's actually possible to create a cached version, and it's also possible to parallel download files. There's a lot of possibilities in this handler here, and the documentation on this is pretty good from Spring's side, I think. Of course, the examples could be better, but I think the default documentation is really, really good. So that's all for me for tonight. Feel free to leave a comment as usual, and I hope to see you again very soon, and have a great evening. Bye-bye.